Let's do a quick recap of what we have discussed in this chapter so far. So what we have talked about are the kinematic properties of physical objects modeled as minuscule particles where all their mass is concentrated. And some of the kinematic quantities that we have been interested in are the position vector, the differential displacement, velocity, and acceleration. And we studied these quantities in three different coordinate systems. One was Cartesian coordinate system. And the other two were curvilinear coordinate system, namely tangent normal and polar, also known as r theta system. And we looked at the velocity expression and acceleration expression in each of these three coordinate systems. Now we're in a good position to actually write down a general method for solving all the kinematics problems for the particles. And the general method is actually fairly simple. So let me start by writing method for solving particle kinematics problems. And as long as you follow this method consistently to solve the problems, you'll see that you would have no trouble pretty much solving any problem in this particular chapter. So the step one of this method is to look at the problem, look at the input information given to you, and choose either one or many coordinate system. So I'll write choose coordinate system, and in parentheses I'll write S, because in some problems you may have to choose two different coordinate systems and be able to relate the various kinematic properties in the two coordinate system to be able to solve the problem, and we'll see an example of that. So choose coordinate system. Okay, so this could be, there are three choices, right? You have Cartesian, you have tangent normal, I'll write it as TN, and you have r theta. Okay, step two is show your chosen coordinate system as well as position variables. So this could amount to, you know, just showing your coordinate system like this, saying this is O, X, Y, and here's my particle, and then that's my position vector of the particle P. Okay, or if it was tangent normal system or r theta system, then you might show a path, you know, here's the particle, you say this is my tangent vector and this is my normal vector. Okay, and if you have r theta system, you do something similar. So just showing the coordinate system and position variable is going to be very important, because if I'm looking at, you know, your solution to the problems, I need to know where your coordinate system is located and how your position variables are indicated. Step three of this process is to write down velocity and acceleration expression in chosen coordinate systems. So if you have chosen only Cartesian coordinate system, then you need to write its velocity. You would start with position vector and then velocity and acceleration. If you choose tangent normal, then you write the velocity expression in tangent system, tangent normal system and acceleration, and same thing with the polar coordinate system. And finally, you will solve for the unknowns from the velocity and acceleration expressions. And that's all there is to solving problems in this chapter. So let's do a simple example, okay? Where what I will try to do is, I'll try to bring in all the three coordinate systems, and you can see how they will all relate to one another, okay? And I'll choose a simple example of a particle moving along a circular track, along a circular path. So this could be a car that's moving along a circular track, this could be an aeroplane, you know, traveling along a circular path, it could be a vertical plane, it could be a horizontal plane, or it could be just an electron actually orbiting around the nucleus, okay? So it doesn't matter, but they're all going to be modeled as a particle P, which is located a certain distance away from the center of this path. All right, so let's start first with the Cartesian coordinate system. So I'm going to locate the origin of my coordinate system right at the center of this circle, and this will be my x, this is my y, which means that this is my I hat direction, and that's my j hat direction. Okay, so at any particular instant, let's say this angle is theta, okay, and it's moving along counterclockwise direction, the position of the particle is given as x I hat plus y j hat. Okay, now since I know the distance from the origin, I can also write this as r cosine theta I hat plus r sine theta j hat, right? And there's no problem with that. I want to get the velocity, I differentiate it, and I get minus r sine theta theta dot I hat plus r cosine theta theta dot j hat. Okay, so that gives me the velocity. If I want to get the acceleration, I differentiate it once more, and I'll take my r outside, and I'll write this as minus cosine theta theta dot square plus sine theta theta double dot I hat plus r, this will be minus sine theta theta dot squared plus cosine theta theta double dot, and that's j hat. And that's your acceleration in Cartesian coordinate system. So if you know theta dot, you know theta double dot, you know the r, you can compute any of these quantities, right? Okay, now I'm going to pick a different color. Let's say I want to indicate its velocity and acceleration in tangent normal system. What would that be? So at this particular instant where the particle p is, what is the tangential direction? That's same as direction of velocity, so that's et hat, right over here, and the en hat would be pointing this way. Okay, so if I want to write velocity in tangent normal system, that would be whatever its magnitude is, the speed, times et hat, right? And if I want to write the acceleration, that would be v dot et hat, so tangential component, plus v square over radius of curvature, which is r en hat. Now if somebody said, can you go from this to this, you can easily go that way, because you know at this point your I hat is pointing this way and j hat is pointing that way, and you can relate to the I hat, j hat with et hat and en hat. In fact, quite a few problems in this chapter will be just relating the two coordinate system. So if I want to write, let's say, I hat in terms of et hat and en hat, it would be a simple matter of just showing the two coordinate system. So I'm going to draw this separately. So this is my I hat, this is my j hat, right? And et hat is pointing this way, and en hat is perpendicular to et hat, of course, right? So this is perpendicular, this is perpendicular, and the angle that en hat is making from horizontal is actually theta. So if I said, can you write, let's say, et hat in terms of I hat and j hat, or I hat in terms of et hat and en hat, you could do that, it's not a problem. So if this angle is theta, this angle is theta as well, so I can write et hat equal to cosine theta j hat minus sine theta I hat, right? So it's just a simple matter of writing a particular vector in a chosen coordinate system. So in this case, I'm choosing to write e sub t hat in terms of I hat and j hat. What about en hat? En hat would be equal to minus cosine theta I hat minus sine theta j hat. Okay, and if you are having trouble seeing how we obtain this, you will need to review the review material that I posted on Blackboard and go to the section where we talk about the vectors, and I have a couple of examples of how you go from one coordinate system to another. So now if you take this, okay, and you substitute in over here in the expression for velocity as well as in the acceleration, and you do the same thing with the en hat, you will actually get the velocity and acceleration in terms of I hat and j hat, and they will be same as what you have over here in 1 and 2. There won't be any different. Okay, all right, so what about r theta? Well, at this point p, and I'll choose a different color this time, what is the direction of er hat? Remember, er hat points radially outward, so that would be er hat, and e theta hat points in the increasing theta direction, so that actually would be same as et hat direction. Okay, so you could also write velocity and acceleration in r theta system. So what would that be? So let's do that. So velocity of p is r dot er hat plus r theta dot e theta hat, and acceleration is r double dot minus r theta dot square er hat plus 2 r dot theta dot plus r theta double dot e theta hat. So now again, if you wanted to relate the velocity and acceleration in our theta system with tangent normal or Cartesian system, you can clearly see how they would relate. In fact, er hat at this instant is equal to minus en hat, right? Because they're pointing in the opposite direction. So you could write er hat is nothing but minus en hat, okay? What about e theta hat? E theta hat is same as tangent direction. So e theta hat is equal to tangent direction, right? And that's it. So if you know how to go from one quantity system to another, you can easily relate any of these quantities without a problem.